Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are making some super easy, super tasty and super duper healthy snack recipes. These are made with the ingredients that are present in the kitchen mostly in every household. So I've tried to use ingredients that are mostly there in our kitchen, the dry ingredients. All these recipes are vegetarian and these are basically for people who actually don't like to spend too much time in the kitchen and they want something healthy as well. So I hope you like all the recipes and let me know in the comment section below which one did you like the most. So without further ado, let's get started. So we are starting off with a very easy and fun recipe. This is a recipe I made by accident. I really like the combination of chickpea salad and papad, and I thought why not make tacos out of this papad. So I have taken 2 cups of boiled chickpeas and I'm adding 1.5 spoon of olive oil to add some good fats. Now I'm adding in 1 cup of roughly chopped cucumber. Now 1/2 cup of tomatoes. Now 1/4 cup of roughly chopped onion and some fresh coriander. Adding in 1 teaspoon of sesame seeds, 1 tablespoon of flax seeds. All the seeds are optional. If you don't have them, it's fine. Some salt to taste. 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon powder, 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, and 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. Now we'll sprinkle some chaat masala and we'll give it all a good mix. Now just for your information, I had soaked these chickpeas overnight and I pressure cooked them for 5 whistles. Like I just boiled them like we normally do, and our chickpea salad is ready. It's very healthy, you can have it as it is. Now I just felt a little extra that day and I thought, you know, instead of just roasting some papads, I thought why not, you know, make tacos and make it fun for kids, and you know, it just looks very presentable and looks really nice. So I've just roasted the papad and while it is still hot, I am trying to give it the taco shape with the help of a rolling pin. Now I'm filling in the salad. Now obviously you can skip this step of, you know, making a taco. You can make your papad and you can enjoy it with your chickpea salad. Trust me, it's the best combination. I really love my salads, especially chickpea salad with papad. Now chickpeas are an excellent source of protein for all vegetarian and vegans, and they are just, you know, very high in fiber also, so they'll help you manage your weight properly as they keep you full for very long, and they support your heart health, very good for your digestion as they are high in fiber. Now coming on to the next recipe, which is super duper easy and you need not do any cooking for this. It's for people who, like, you know, just dread the idea of cooking in the kitchen. So these are soaked chana dal. I've soaked it for 4-5 hours and I've taken around 1 cup of soaked chana dal. Now 1.5 cup of puffed rice or murmura or lai as we call it, I'm adding to it. Now I'm just adding in the vegetables, that is your onion, tomatoes and cucumbers, and little bit of fresh coriander and green chili. Now I'm adding in 1/4 teaspoon of black salt, some salt. Now sometimes I don't have cucumbers, so I just make it with onion and tomato. Now I'm squeezing in juice from 1 medium-sized lemon and just sprinkling some chaat masala, and we're done. This is super easy and this is my favorite go-to snack. Like when I'm you know, when I have no idea what to cook or what to eat, I just make this. It's very easy and very healthy at the same time, and it's very tasty. Coming on to the next recipe, this is basically your kala chana chaat or black chickpea chaat. High in iron, fiber, protein and vitamins and minerals, this is a great snack and it's extremely tasty. So in a pan, I'm adding in 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. Coconut oil is a very healthy fat and you should definitely include it in your diet. Now I'm adding in 2 cups of boiled chickpeas which I had soaked overnight. Let them cook for like 4-5 minutes in that coconut oil. It gives a really good flavor and taste to it. So I'm adding in 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 3/4 teaspoon of red chili powder, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Cook it for another 3-4 minutes. Now transferring the cooked black chickpeas to a bowl, adding in onion, 1 roughly chopped, then 2 tomatoes roughly chopped, some fresh coriander and green chili. One teaspoon of black salt and juice from 1 big lemon. Now just give it all a good mix. Sprinkle in some chaat masala and mix it well. Now while I was recording this video, I thought that I didn't have cucumbers, but then I had them, so I added them. So if you have them, they are a great addition. Otherwise, if you don't have them, it's fine. Please try this recipe the way I made it, or you know, after frying them a little in little bit of coconut oil, it tastes amazing, like better than what you get in the streets. So just try it out. Now coming on to the next recipe, which is super duper healthy and so freaking yum. It's a recipe of your basic chaal mudi made at home. So I've taken 4 handful of puffed rice and I've just roasted it in a pan, and I'm quickly transferring it to a bowl. Now we'll roast a handful of chana or gram in the same pan and transfer it to the same bowl. Now roasting some peanuts and transferring it to the same bowl. Now in a separate bowl, I have taken some onion, some tomatoes, some boiled potatoes, and 1 small sweet potato. Now if you don't have any of these items, you can obviously customize it according to what you have, adding in some green chili, some red chili powder, 3/4 teaspoon of black salt, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 2 teaspoon of mustard oil. Now adding in some fresh coriander. Sprinkling in some chaat masala. And adding juice from 1 big lemon. Now just mix it all really well. Now add all your dry roasted ingredients. Now mix it all really well and it's done. You can enjoy it with your tea. It works as a great tea time snack. Now moving on to the next recipe. This recipe you can actually make in bulk and store it and use it for your entire lockdown period. Roasting some puffed rice. When it will turn slightly brown, I'll quickly transfer it to a bowl. So while roasting everything, your flame should be on low to medium at all times. Now I'm roasting some flattened rice or poha. When it will turn slightly brown, I'll transfer it to a bowl. So I've made very little quantity of this namkeen. You can actually make it in bulk, so you can increase the quantity accordingly. So in the same pan, I've added some oil. Now I'm adding in some curry leaves and 4 tablespoons of peanuts I've added, around 8 to 10 almonds, some fresh coconut. If you don't have fresh coconut, you can also add dry coconut. If you don't have coconut, you can totally skip putting coconut. Now I've added some turmeric, some red chili powder, and 1/4 teaspoon of dry mango powder. So just fry this mixture until the peanuts are a bit crunchy. I'm adding in some salt to it. Now I'm adding in a handful of fox nuts or makhana or lotus seeds, and we'll just, you know, cook it on low flame until it is all crunchy. Now adding in the roasted puffed rice and poha and just mixing it all, and just let it cook for 5 minutes more and add in some salt and red chili powder, adding in some black salt as well. So our roasted and healthy namkeen is done. I hope you enjoyed this recipe, and I hope you enjoyed all the other recipes as well. They were all somewhat on similar lines, made with similar ingredients. So yeah, let me know your feedback in the comment section below, and also let me know which one did you like the most. So thank you so much for watching. Happy cooking. Bye bye.